Hello everyone, I am Deepa Telang, Assistant Professor in Civil Engineering Department, GHRAET Academy of Engineering and Technology. Today's topic is the equilibrium. At the last of the test lecture, you will be able to understand what is the meaning of equilibrium. First of all, we see what is the meaning of equilibrium. To understand the meaning of equilibrium, I draw a diagram, I draw a block. Which having the number of forces suppose that forces will be F1, F2, F3, F4 and F5. That means the block or that block, the total 5 forces is acting. That due to that the 5 forces, we can say that the block, that is the block, we can say due to that number of, due to that 5 forces, the block will be disturbed. The block will be disturbed. That means the body, due to that number of forces, the block either the move in horizontal direction or either the move in vertical direction. How that block will be disturbed? I will replace that 5 forces into a single force. That is our x axis, y axis. That single force, it is called as a resultant force. Here we are showing that the number of forces, the system of the number of forces, the effect of that number of forces is a single force, and that single force, it is called as the resultant. That resultant is acting inclined with an angle of theta. That inclination of angle with respect to the x, here considering as the angle, inclination of angle with respect to x. Here we are considering that the resultant acting in a upward direction. That means for only we are considering for that system, that is the resultant is acting vertically upward. It is assumption for that we are considering the resultant is acting vertically upward. It is the single force. Since it is a single inclined force, it having the two components, that is horizontal component and the vertical component. Means the resultant force is resolved into that there are two components, that is the horizontal component and that vertical component. Since due to the effect of that components, the body can be moved in a horizontal manner or in a vertical manner. Means due to the effect of that resultant, the body will get disturbed in horizontally, in vertically. That means the resultant act as a disturbing force. In also other way, we can say that the resultant is a unbalanced force the system. The resultant is unbalancing the force system. That means due to the unbalance of the force, this the block can be moved in a horizontal manner or in a vertical manner. If due to that resultant force the body get disturbed, if you want to remove that disturbing force, for that if you want to maintain the state of rest of that body, for that you have to replace the another new force, that force is a equilibrium force. That force, it is called as the equilibrium force. The how that equilibrium force it show? To show the equilibrium force, it is just we are denoting that equilibrium force with a capital E. That resultant, that equilibrium force, it just opposite to that of resultant force. We are denoting here the resultant, the equilibrium force with a capital E, opposing to the direction of resultant. If the resultant is acting with an inclination of angle is theta, the same we can say that the equilibrium force is also inclined with an angle of theta. That means the equilibrium force, the angle between the resultant, the angle between the resultant force and the angle between the equilibrium force are both are in the same. Only the difference is that the equilibrium force is acting with opposite in nature, only equal in magnitude, collinear to the resultant force. Means the equilibrium force have the same value as the value of that resultant force. That means that due to the value, if the value is same, therefore the effect of that resultant will be nullified due to the equilibrium force. That means due to the same value of resultant and equilibrium force, the system get position. That means we can say that due to that equilibrium force, if the body is in rest condition, it remain at the rest position because it opposes the resultant force. That means we can say that the equilibrium force is that force, it is a single force which cancel the effect of the resultant force, which cancel the effect of resultant force. Due to that, the body is maintain its equilibrium condition, means the state of rest of condition. If due to the effect of the resultant force is act as a disturbing force, due to that the body, if it is moving in a horizontal manner, it can be stopped due to that the resultant force. And if the body is moving in continuous manner, due to the resultant force, it can be stopped. If you have to maintain the equilibrium position, you have to apply the equilibrium force. That equilibrium force is nullified, or we can say that that equilibrium force is cancel the effect of that resultant force. Due to that the system maintain its state of rest of condition. Means if the body is in a state in condition, the body remain in a state position. Now, if the body is in moving, it continues to the moving in that direction. That condition, it is called as the equilibrium conditions. Means in that condition, we can say that the resultant force is equal to the zero. That the due to that equilibrium force, the effect of that resultant is cancel, means the R equal to zero, means that the R equal to zero. If the R resultant is nothing but the summation of under root of summation of summation fx equal to fx square plus summation fy square. Due to that, if the we can say that if the system is in equilibrium, means the resultant equal to the zero. From this we can say that the equilibrium force is that force, it is a single force which cancels the effect of that resultant and the maintain the system is in equilibrium conditions. That the equilibrium conditions to maintain the body is in state of rest of conditions. In that, if we can say that the body is in equilibrium, that means the resultant force acting on that body is equal to the zero. Is here we see that the block block having the five number of forces acting on this system. It is a concurrent coplanar force system. In the system, if we can say that that system is in equilibrium condition, then the value of resultant is equal to the zero. And therefore, according to that, we can say that the condition of equilibrium, that is summation R equal to zero, summation fx equal to zero, summation fy equal to zero, because the resultant equal to the zero. Up till we see that to eliminate the effect of the resultant force, we require the equilibrium force. That equilibrium force means cancel the effect of the resultant force. Due to that equilibrium force, the body or the system will be stable, and the value of equilibrium force and the resultant force is same. That condition, it is called as the equilibrium condition. To the use of that equilibrium condition to solve the unknown, the value of unknown forces in concurrent force system, we are applying here the equilibrium condition to solve the unknown forces A and B. For that, here is a problem in that you have to determine the magnitude of forces A and B for the force system which is in a equilibrium as shown in figure. The condition of the problem is given that the body, the system is in equilibrium. That system is in equilibrium condition. If the system is in equilibrium, for that you have to find out the value of A and value of B. If we say that the system is in equilibrium, that means the value of R is equal to zero, the resultant force equal to the zero. It is the concurrent force system. If the resultant equal to the zero, the forces acting on that resultant is equal to the zero. Therefore, the equilibrium condition for the concurrent force system, that is the summation fx equal to 0 and the summation fy equal to 0. That condition is helped to find out the value of A and B. The first aim of that problem, you have to find out the what is the value of A and what is the value of B with the help of equilibrium condition. the equilibrium condition is summation fx equal to 0 and summation fy equal to 0. Let us start our problem by considering the equilibrium condition. Our first aim is you have to find out the value of A and the value of B. In that given force system, it is given that the force A is an incline with an angle of 60 degree. Then force B is acting vertically downward, and the force, third force, that is the force with magnitude 15 Newton inclined with an angle of 30 degree. It is our x axis, and that is, it is our y axis. We know that since the force A and the force 50 Newton is an incline, therefore there is a need of resolve that forces into their two component. That two component means you have to resolve that the incline force A in a horizontal manner and in a vertical manner. The resolution of that force A with a horizontally, we can say that A cos 60. If the angle with respect to the x, the horizontal component is cos, that is the A cos 60. Similarly, the vertical component of A, that is A sin 60. In the similar way, we have to resolve the inclined force 50 Newton into their two component, that is the horizontal component and that is in a vertical component. The angle with respect to the x axis inclined with the 30 degree, therefore the x component is 50 cos 30, and our vertical component is 50 sin 30. Here is the resolution part is over. The force B is acting vertically downward. It is a vertical force. Therefore, there is no need to resolve that forces. The first of all, we can solve how the value of A and B is find out with the help of equilibrium condition. Therefore, first we are considering the summation fx. Summation fx equal to 0. Our sign convention is that the towards the right we are considering is a positive force, and towards the left is considering negative forces. The sign convention is towards the right is positive and towards the left it is negative. Therefore, summation fx, by using the equilibrium condition, summation fx equal to 0 with sign condition, towards the right is positive and towards the left it is negative. Therefore, A cos 60, the force A cos 60 is acting towards the right, therefore we are taking it is as a positive A cos 60. Then the another force, that is the 50 cos 30, that 50 cos 30 is acting toward the left, therefore we are considering it is as a negative, that is 50 cos 30. The third force, it is vertically downward, but we are considering here only the summation of horizontal forces equal to 0, therefore we are considering the here it is a horizontal forces. Therefore, on the for the force system, only the two horizontal forces is acting, A cos 60 minus 50 cos 30 is equal to the 0. The A cos 60, by calculating the A cos 60 is, cos 60 is equal to the 0.5 A. minus 50 cos 30. Cos 60, that is 0.5 A minus the value of 50 cos 30 is equal to the 43 43.3 equal to 0. That is A equal to 43.3 divided by 0.5, that is equal to the 86.6 Newton. Our first aim is find out, that is the value of A is 86.6. Now, to find out the value of B, we are considering the summation Fy is equal to the 0. Summation Fy equal to the 0. The summation Fy, it is nothing but the algebraic sum of all the vertical forces. Our sign convention is the vertical force is positive and the vertically downward force is negative. There, the summation of Fy equal to 0, with sign convention, vertical force is positive and vertically downward force is a negative. The first of all, we are considering the force component of A sin 60. A sin 60 is acting vertically upward. Therefore, the value of, we are considering here the value of A sin 60 with positive sign. Same, we are going through the second force, that is the 50. The component, vertical component of 50 Newton is plus 50 sin 30. And then third force, that is the unknown force, it is acting vertically downward. That means, that is negative B equal to the 0. From the above equation, we have calculated that the value of A is 86.6 Newton. We are just putting that value in our equation A sin 60, that is the value of A is 86.6 sin 60 plus 50 sin 30 minus B equal to 0. While calculating the value of A sin 60 is nothing but equal to the 74, that is 74.99. The 74.99 we are considering at, it is a 75 plus the 50. After calculating the value of 50 sin 30, it is the 25 minus B equal to the 0. While calculating the value of B, we get the value of B is equal to 75 plus 25, that is equal to the 100 Newton. By using the equilibrium condition, summation fx equal to 0 and summation fy equal to the 0. Summation fx equal to 0 and summation fy equal to 0. We are calculating the unknown value of forces A and B. We get the value of A by taking the summation fx, means the algebraic sum of all the horizontal forces equal to the 0. With the sign convention, towards the right it positive, towards the left it is negative. And we get the value of B by considering the summation Fy, means the algebraic sum of all the vertical forces is equal to the 0. The sign convention, vertical force is positive and vertical down force is negative. And we get the value of B equal to 100 Newton.